You're listening to the Create What You Speak podcast, where I invite you to come along with me as we shape our own reality together. My intention is to bring out the magic in you. Now let's get started.
Come along now, run away from the humdrum. We'll go to a place that is safe from greed, anger, and boredom. We'll dance and sing till sundown, and feast with abandon. We'll sleep when the morning comes, and we'll rise by the sound of the bird song.
My name is Sloane Fremont, and today I want to talk to you about the white ball of light.
I went to see a healer with that mic strapped to his face. Talked about which habits to surrender and which habits to embrace. For the next few days or so,
all right, welcome to another week of the Create What You Speak podcast. My name is Sloane Fremont and welcome to the show. If you're new, I'm so glad you're here. If you've been here for a while, welcome back. This week I want to tell you about something really interesting. So you might be wondering about the title of the show, White Ball of Light. Like, what does that mean? So let me explain. Okay. So one of the things I've been working on lately, the past, I don't know, 3 or 4 weeks, I'll say, since I really decided to change my approach with the show and just what I was doing to, for my part in the Great Awakening. Okay. That's what I'm going to call it. What I'm doing, like what, how I feel like I can help humanity. One of the things I've been practicing and really working more on is channeling with my guides. And this is still, this is weird for me to talk about. This is not something that, it feels odd to me and I'm not super comfortable with it, but I think it's important because the information I'm getting is, it's what I want to convey to you. And I'm even asking those questions when I converse with my guides. How can I help my listeners? What can I tell them? What message, you know, do I need to get out to people today? And so this one that came through about the white ball of light is very interesting. I also think it can help everyone who's listening. So before I get into explaining that, I want to just talk just a little bit about channeling and my approach and what it means to me. So first off, I'm not an expert in channeling. I'll say that to start out with. In my understanding of channeling is there's really two types. There's trans channeling, where it's almost like the energy enters your body and you're, you know, sometimes you might see this as people, speaking in a different tone or their mannerism is different or their body changes, like their body language changes. And then there's more of the channeling where you connect energetically. And when I talk about channeling, that's what I'm talking about, that energetic connection. It's staying within your body, which is all, it's also different than meditation because meditation is where, you know, you go into meditation, just freeing your mind of anything. And sometimes with meditation, you might hover between sleep and awake, like you might be right on the verge of sleeping, but there's still obviously benefit to that, right? There's meditation has tons of benefits, but that's different than channeling. And when I'm talking about channeling, you're in your body. You're not in that meditative state, but your eyes are closed. You're breathing, you know, calmly. Your body is calm, but you're aware. You're aware of that you're in a room or you're in, you know, wherever you are, you're aware of your space. And what you're doing is really going within yourself, like connecting inside of you. And then it's almost like you're putting this like energetic pulse out and calling in your guides, your galactic team, your whatever entities want to come in for your highest good. You're calling them in, and then you're connecting with them energetically. And how this comes through for me is the energetic connection. I receive pictures sometimes, and or it's like a deciphering of the energy that I feel. It happens sort of fast for me, so I don't always know exactly like the process of it. I just know that I get the information. It's really interesting. It's fun. It's putting me like in connection with myself at another level. And it's also, I think, it's a great way to really go in and connect with that bigger aspect of ourselves that's really the universe, right? Like all of these things that happen outside of what we see in the 3D. I don't really worry too much about any bad entities coming in. I've never had an experience with that. I would say I've been doing channeling like at a scattered level for probably 2 or 3 years now. And what I mean by scattered level is I'm not doing it in any format, or I didn't really understand like what I was supposed to be doing. I just did what I thought was right, or what felt good to me. But what I've been practicing in these past couple weeks is more for, I guess I would call it more formalized, right? Like more of a structure around it. I took a class on this to like dig into this a little deeper and understand it more, that I found really valuable. So that's something I've been working on. And so each time when I go into channel, there's a process I follow that is, if you're interested in learning how to channel, I would suggest finding someone to teach it to you. I'm definitely not at a place to teach it, but there are a lot of good people out there that can teach it and explain the process better than me. But anyway, so when I'm going into this channeling, right, I'm calling in my galactic team. I'm calling in entities that want to connect with me, and I'm pulsating my own energy out to connect with them and see what I'm getting. And so I get different energetic entities that come in. I don't fully understand all these different groups that I get access to. Some of you who have channeled for a while, maybe you understand these groups. But there's different angels that come in. There's archangels, there's Pleiadians, there's again people I don't understand, I don't know, and I don't know that it really matters, names of any, you know, things like that. Sometimes I can tell the energy, or I can feel the energy, like if it's male or female. Sometimes it's no gender at all. Sometimes there's no words spoken. Sometimes I just feel an energetic resonance. It's more like a softening or a comforting feeling. But this particular instance that I had, and what the topic of today is about the white ball of light, was there was, a Pleiadian that came in named Tara, and it was both male and female energy. I don't know. It was like a neutral energy. It wasn't, that was like a non-issue. But as she was talking to me, she asked for my hand, and I put my hand out, and she gave me what she called the white ball of light to use. And what it's like the size of a golf ball. I would say it was like silvery white energy with like think of like a solid, like a golf ball size, like solid white silver light with like a sphere around it kind of that went bigger than the actual ball. And what she told me, what she gave me this to keep with me, almost like a good luck charm maybe, or a talisman, right? To keep like as a, almost like as a reminder of who you are, right? This is your, like you have all this energy in the palm of your hand, that you have this energy that you can use to create whatever you want. You can use this as a way to, you know, shield yourself from something. You can use it as a way to clear your energy after something, right? So like with the clearing of the energy, I picture like Cinderella with like the fairy godmother tapping the wand, and like the silver shimmery goes around Cinderella and then she transitions, right? That's what this like clearing the energy feels like with me with this white ball of light. She gave this to me, or suggested I could use this. I think I mentioned before my boyfriend is getting to deploy to the Middle East. She suggested using this as a way to like actually take the ball of light and like throw it and send him a message, like send his higher self a message from me. Really in any way that I want to use it, I can use it. And I wanted to share that with you today. One, because I thought the whole channeling thing is obviously I'm really interested in it. I wanted to talk about it on the show. Like I said, it is something I'm, you know, getting more used to talking about. It's not something I've talked about that much. But also I wanted to share it as something that you can use in your own life. Like it's not just limited to me, right? Like she gave it to me, but anyone can use it. Anyone can imagine this silvery white ball of light and have it with them, carry it with them, take it with them, right? You can use this just like I mentioned, like for protection. You can use this as clearing. One of the things I did just actually today, I was feeling like I was in a really lower vibrational state, and I was feeling very anxious about my relationship with my boyfriend. I was feeling very much like, unsettled, like just very low vibe energy. And when I was in the bathtub, then later the day, I had been feeling like this all day, just not good. I was sick of feeling this low. And so what I did is I was in the tub and I was just relaxing. And what I imagined was taking this white ball of light and like having it circle me and like almost going through me, like touching my heart, touching my mind, like touching like my soul and like clearing out all this low vibrational energy and deciding that the new energy is going to be more of like, especially as it comes to love, like I deserve love. Like I get to have love. I get to have this. I don't have to be fearful of it or worry that I don't get to have it. Like I used the white ball of light as a clearing to clear out the old energy and bring in the new. And I found that very helpful. It was very helpful to envision that. It was very helpful to almost like reset the tone of my own energy and my own vibration. And so I wanted to tell you that story today, as something you could use, a tool you can use in your own life, the white ball of light. That's what she called it. That's what it was called when she gave it to me. And I asked about sharing it and she said, absolutely. It's not limited to you. Anybody can pick up on this energy, take it and use it to benefit themselves. And, so I wanted to share that with you. I hope that helps you if you're listening. And, I would love to hear if you do use it, how it helps you and how it worked in your life. So, I would love to hear from you. A couple other things I found interesting from some of my channeling was, so I had an angel next to me that was very tall, just pulsating like this loving energy. Like I just felt like wrapped in this warm, like loving energy, which felt so good during one of my channeling sessions. And then, one of the messages they gave me that they were helping to shine the light on my path. And that also, I think that white ball of light came in with that too. Like it was like a flashlight to like not be fearful about the future, like not be scared about the unknown. Like I had this with me and like they were with me and they were going to be with me as I walked into the future. And this white ball of light was going to help shine the light on that. Like, cause what I pictured was like being in the dark and like not knowing the path, right? Like just being in complete pitch black dark and like having this white ball of light with me and being guided by them and not feeling fearful of the future. One of the other things that they told me was, this was Saint Germain mentioned to me a new race identified called the Neo-Ephesians, and that I have a big part in that. I have no idea what that means. I don't know what Neo-Ephesians means. I did not look that up. I'm trying not to look up things online when I get them, because I don't want to rely on other people's information or other things that might, you know, come in later. And then I start to question, well, wait a minute, is this real or am I making this up? Right. And that's one of the things about channeling that I've really started. I made a decision on is that I'm just going to trust. I'm going to trust the messages that I get, no matter what they are. I'm deciding to believe this. Like I'm deciding that I get to have this. And, we talked about this on, last week's episode about trusting ourselves. Right. And so this is one of those areas that I'm working on for myself, to trust myself and trust these messages that I'm getting and these energetic connections that I'm making. There was another message about the general wake up call movement. And I don't really know what this one means either, but I found it interesting calling the general wake up call movement. And then I have Max. And I think there was someone named Max, because sometimes I get these right before I'm falling asleep too. And, so I try to write them down, but I don't always do a good job. The last one that I wanted to tell you about is Archangel Michael came in and he was very adamant when he came in and he said, I have a message for you. And it was very like concise and crisp and like to the point, like I have a message for you. And it came very fast and it was just like that, flip of a switch. You will know soon. No need to fear. Like those four statements came in like boom, boom, boom. Just like that, flip of a switch, you will know soon, no need to fear. And so I was like, okay, what does that mean? And I didn't get any more after at that session. And then my next session after that, what I got was that flip of a switch, just like that, the virus is gone. So that's what I got. So anyway, I found that to be very interesting, all of that. So I'm going to be talking about that some more on upcoming episodes. I do hope you found the white ball of light as something that you might be able to use in your own life. At least if you don't, at least hopefully you found it interesting as the way it came through for me and kind of how I'm using that energetically in my own life. All right, so that's it for this week. I'll talk about the songs I picked and then I will close out the show. Okay, so our intro song is called Didn't Fix Me by Dawes. And this is one of their newer songs. And I feel like we all can relate to all of the verses in this song because it talks about, he says, I went to see your healer with that mic strapped to his face, talked about which habits to surrender and which habits to embrace. And for the next few days or so, I was feeling pretty good, but it didn't fix me. And then another verse, I finally got a nomination for a word that I don't need, but I say that out of obligation. I really spent hours on my speech. And I thanked my biggest inspirations and the good folks back in Hollywood, but it didn't fix me. It didn't fix me like I thought it would. And the whole song is about that, these different scenarios where, you know, we do these things because we think they're going to fix us and then they don't, right? And fixing, and I'm putting air quotes, like fixing is an inside job. I mean, it's not outside of us, right? We talked about this last week. Like the seeking outside of us doesn't work. It never did work. But I think right now we're coming to this point where we have to change, right? We have to do something different about that because it's not sustainable. So this song reminds me of that, about going within ourselves, trusting ourselves and looking for the answers within, not outside of us. And then the outro song is called I'm Not For Everyone by Brothers Osborne. And so this song to me is just about, you know, we're all different and that's okay, right? They talk about some people clap on the 1 and 3, some people clap on the 2 and 4, some just don't join at all because they've got no rhythm and that's all right. Some people drink too much, some people don't drink enough, some people are just like me, I hope you all forgive them. And then he goes through some different things, like I'm always speaking my mind when I'm better off biting my tongue. I'm a bad joke at the wrong time. Hell, I'm a legend in my own mind. I'm good for some, but I'm not for everyone. And I think that's just another example of how, you know, we're all different and it's okay. Like, it's like, to me, this song is about embracing that we can be different and it's okay. We're not, none of us are for everyone and there's nothing wrong with that. That's not wrong or bad or anything like that. It's absolutely just fine. So, I just thought this was a good song. So that's our closing song, I'm Not For Everyone by Brothers Osborne. All right, so that's it for our topic this week on the white ball of light. I would love to know what you think. If you have any questions or comments, please email me, SloanFremont@pm.me. That's SloanFremont@pmproton.me. My new social media accounts, I'm on Parler, Mayway, and I also have a Telegram channel. I'll have the links to all of those in the show notes. And I would love to have you on the Telegram channel. It's free to join. Telegram to me has been a great way to get information. Also, as things become a little more crazy with censorship, we don't have that risk with Telegram. So that's it for me this week. Thank you for listening. And remember, question everything, trust yourself, and find your truth.
Some people clap on a 1 and 3. Some people clap on a 2 and 4. Some people don't join at all because they got no rhythm. That's all right. Some people, they drink too much. Some people don't drink enough. Some people are just like me. I hope y'all forgive them. I'm like Scott.